What is going on, my beautiful people of the world? I hate fighting games. That's a good note to start off on. But, I mean, partially it's just the simple fact that, like, there is no other game genre in the world that requires as much effort just to get in the door. You know, like, you're sitting outside that hopping new club, and then the guard's just like, nah, training mode for at least 27 hours, motherfucker. Until I see a record that states you've been in the lab for that long, you don't get to step foot up in this bitch. Don't even try to get past me. I'll know. And then, you know, so you gotta go through so much effort, so much time, just to get to, like, a base level of goodness. And then on top of that, just to learn the, like, that's all just to learn the game, and then you gotta learn characters, and if you want, like, you're interested in more than one character, the quality of one of them is sacrificed in order to get some quality with the other one. And so it's like, I mean, right now, bar none, there's no debating it, Azrael is my best character. Like I said, there's no debate about that. If somebody sat me down and said, bitch, you win this match, I would pick Azrael. But then it's like, I want to learn Hakumen, right? I want to learn Susanoo. I want to learn Tager. And like, it's because, you know, Tager, Tager. I do legitimately think this is the worst version of Tager we've seen since Continuum Shift. I don't care for him very much. And largely that's not really a problem necessarily with the character itself. I mean, him being the worst version of himself since Continuum Shift is a problem, and that should not have happened, but it did, and, you know, arc system works balancing, you get used to it. But a large reason why he just doesn't sit well with me is because almost everything that I liked about him, almost everything that I did enjoy about him, they took away. Like, I don't know, I don't want to get into specifics because that would take far too long. But it's just, and so that's just not managing. I can't wrap my head around this new Tager and actually get to a point of, like, quality with him because I am so stuck in the past, basically. And that's just a weird place to be. But anyway, I had a question for all you lovely people before I actually came over here. Here. Speedstar. I have a question. Now, number one, I just want to show you this. This is hilarious to me. Can you tell which character is the best to beat this particular route? that amazed me. But I want to know, what do people know about Naoto that I don't, that make him ideal for this? Like, I understand Tarumi, right? Because you get huge payoffs for using a lot of meter, whether it's through rapid canceling or using distortions or whatever. You get a lot of extra time for using meter with your characters, and obviously there is nobody in the cast better at building meter than Tarumi. And Tager, I get it, because it's really easy to just abuse the AI with the character. I shouldn't say really easy, because there are certain points where the AI is just like, nah, fuck it, we're just gonna read literally everything you do and not let anything work, have fun trying to get us. But I mean, in terms of, like, ease of use, just spamming sledge over and over and then spamming 720s when you have the meter, eventually it's gonna work. When it comes to the AI, you're basically dealing with a coin flip, and eventually enough coin flips will go your way that you will beat this mode just through being, like, the scrubbiest Tager imaginable. But where does Naoto fall into this? Like, why? What do people know about the character? Now, number one, this is an obscene amount of time bonus to have. Like, I have no idea how they do. I would love to see a video of how these people have done it. Because I haven't beaten Corsine. I probably never will. And I'll talk about that in a second while we're hopefully, like, kind of waiting for matches or whatever. I want to check out ranked first. Let me check, make sure my parameters are good. Cool. Uh-oh, so I'll let this sit here while I talk. And if we don't find anything in the meantime, then I'll head off to player matches. I just want to get the ranking so I can get the last trophy I need. You see, I'm 2-2, so I got the trophy for winning the ranked match. But I need a trophy now for getting rank 11, which apparently is, like, there's one for, like, you'll see right here, it'll say, like, rank measurement or whatever. Once that's over, it assigns you with a rank, and apparently, like, the average is over 11, what people usually get set at. So I'll get that trophy immediately, hopefully. And then the other one is to finish Speed Star. And we'll get into that after this. Cool, this looks like a good connection. Looks like it was the right decision to select three bars. Unfortunately, it's a Kokonoe, though. So this could get interesting. What buttons were they pressing in the middle of getting hit that caused me to get a counter hit there? Hello, lag, my only friend. Why did that hit me? Like, legitimately, why did that hit me? I guess just it's Kokonoe, apparently. I guess that's the reason. Cool, let's just not do anything that I pressed. Cool, let's just not do Growler, which I pressed. What the fuck? I'm fucking sorry? What the fuck? That was horseshit. Alright. Thanks for just losing me the game for no reason. Appreciate that. What the shit? I'm so angry. I'm legitimately angry that that 5A, 5BB didn't connect. Did they reduce the range? Like, that never used to happen, but that's actually happened a few times to me lately. So anyway. Speed Star, course C. The first time I was hoping, because with the score attack trophy, it says, you know, like, you need to beat every single course in order to get this trophy. Now, I was thinking, because there's three difficulties and there's four courses per difficulty, I was thinking, I'm going to have to beat all 12 of these to get this trophy, and that's gonna suck. But then I just did the four off of normal difficulty and it popped the trophy. So I was like, what if there's an exception for Speed Star? And so I beat one character right at the beginning with Azreal, and then I didn't touch it again. And I just let myself lose, hoping that just getting a ranking assigned to me would be enough, and it wasn't. So then I tried it with, I've come back, well anyway, pause. This connection's fine, we can skip the first part. I really just, God, I hate fighting Kokonoe. She's so good all around. I hate fighting good all around characters that don't really have a weakness. Fuck, I suck. He says while he just got two perfects in a row against the character. Shit! I feel so bad. I just bullied this dude. This is Azreal in a nutshell. And this is part of the reason why I love the character. It's so easy to bully people. but it kind of feels bad too. Anyway, so Speedstar. And so I kind of took a break from it because I was kind of like, you know, I don't really, it's single player. We all know my outlook on single player game modes. But then I started playing Susanoo. And one thing I've always held to, and one thing I will always hold to, that single player is always good for. Like, it's not good for learning neutral. It's not good for learning matchups. It's not good for testing, like, mix-up. Because none of those things, the AI never acts like a normal person, and it never will. I shouldn't say it never will, but it certainly won't anytime soon. But it is very good for getting random hits and knowing how to confirm those, and learning how to confirm those random hits. And that's especially helpful with Susanoo, because this, I respect this dude coming back after that. And so the big thing about it with Susanoo is that, like, with most characters, you kind of, you just learn combos for certain scenarios and that's it, right? Like, you kind of, you have your hit confirmed for your fatal counters, you have your hit confirmed for crouching combos. But with Susanoo, you kind of have to do piecemeal combos all the time because you have to unlock moves, and I'll continue that after this. I didn't mean to super jump there. Whoa, that, okay. Shouldn't have bursted that, that was it. That was the end of that combo. Stop rolling. Block high. That actually wasn't about blocking high, they mashed there, but they haven't blocked a single 6B. And so obviously I am inclined to continue mashing it. God damn it. Why does that work? Why is that safe? There is no reason for that to be safe. See, didn't block it, but I gave him credit. More credit than I should have. That sucks. I was gonna rapid that and growler, and then she didn't get hit by it. Okay, that put me way outside range. See, once Kokonoe gets going and, like, once I put her on the defensive, it's basically free, but she's so strong. All of her tools are so strong. Okay, this person's just not blocking high. What am I doing? That's not jump. I tried to jump cancel that. What? That sucks. Why does this work? Why does this work? I don't have meter to rapid that. I'm an idiot. Thankfully, it worked out. I don't know why, I was just thinking, like, I'm gonna rapid cancel this the entire time, and I had, like, 45 meter. So anyway, so Susanoo, so, like, so that is a big aspect of, let me just finish this, because I don't want to keep, like, I don't want to destroy this person's rank, they don't deserve it, they're just getting Asriel, that's not fair. So, one of the biggest aspects of Susanoo that you kind of have to get used to that isn't a part of any other character, is that all of your combo routes are determined by what you have unlocked. I mean, there are ideal scenarios where you always, if you have these four moves unlocked, you're always gonna use one of them, right? But you don't always have that one unlocked. So if you don't have that one unlocked, you wanna go to number two on the list, and number three on the list, down until you get to one that you actually have unlocked. So you have to kinda learn how to piecemeal your combos together, which isn't something that you have to do with any other character. And so I've been doing that lately with Susanoo and really trying to get used to kind of intrinsically knowing, you know, like, all right, at this point in time, if I do this particular combo route, I will be able to use these moves as well as unlock these moves upon using a D move, you know, all that stuff. So trying to get all that just solidified in my head to become a natural aspect of gameplay. And so I've been doing some single player with him, and but you know, just grinding arcade mode over and over, that's not particularly fun. You know, you want to mix it up a bit. So I tried Speed Star with him, and I got to, I want to say, like stage 7 before I got bodied by one of the Marakamo units, because there are certain characters throughout Speed Star that will do nothing. They just run. That's all they do. They just keep their distance. They never close in and like fight you head on. And so for characters like Susanoo or like Tager, it can be difficult to chase them down because they're not particularly good at chasing people down. You have to be super patient and pick your spots to go in, and that's basically the exact opposite of how you want to play Speed Star. And so I just got bodied by one of them, so I was like, all right, let me try this again with Azreal. And I got to like rank 18 where I just got destroyed by Amane. And so then I was like, all right, well, you know, obviously Tager is probably going to be the one I'm going to have the easiest time with this with. Let me try this with Tager. And so let me show you.
Please select your character. Ragna the Blood Edge.
I've defeated 31. I got to the last stage. Now at about stage, I want to say either 28 or 29. I got destroyed by Amane. I was sitting pretty. I thought I was basically in the clear. There was no way I was gonna possibly lose this. I was at like 80 something seconds left. And then I ran into Amane, which for those of you that may not know, that is one of Tager's worst matchups, period. And Amane drained something like 70 seconds off the clock. And then I managed to kind of scrape my way back up to somewhere in the mid 30 seconds left when I got to stage 32, which is always Izanami. And Izanami just decided at that moment that she was not going to get hit by anything that I could do. Like, literally nothing was going to touch her. And so she dodged everything for like 10 seconds, and then she started hitting me, and I lost some time. And around 10 seconds left, she hit me with her little command grab thing that freezes time, and she just gets to go nuts on you. Now, the thing is that things that would normally freeze the clock on you don't freeze the clock in Speed Star. The only thing that I think actually freezes the clock is your own overdrive. But if the opponent overdrives, the clock will not stop. It'll keep going. And so even though normally this would stop the clock, it actually kept winding down. And so I just had to sit there for the last 10 seconds, frozen in this distortion animation, unable to do anything. And I lost. And so I was like, okay, I'm never gonna play this mode again. So even though I'm probably gonna end up at rank 11 at some point in time after finishing this, even though I am going to, that means I will have every single other trophy in the game, I will probably not platinum this game because of Speed Star and because it's a waste of time to play. And I've never been that person that's been like, oh, I have to get the platinum of this game. I have to get all the trophies. It's like, if I can feasibly see myself getting them and enjoying them, I will absolutely go out of my way to get trophies. But in terms of that, where it's like, I spent all that time. I got to stage 32 with Tager, and then I lost because, you know, again, the AI decided to flip the coin and decided that I should probably lose that match. Now, obviously, I'm not going to pretend like there aren't things that I could have done better, but nobody should pretend that the AI is not very cheap and based around that cheapness to try and instill a sense of difficulty in it. And so because of that, it's just kind of like, I got nothing for any. I didn't get any P money. I didn't unlock anything. I got literally nothing for all that time spent getting to stage 32 and then losing. And so you're going to try and tell me that, like, that's something worth doing, potentially doing this over and over and occasionally losing until finally I get it just for some trophy that nobody's ever going to look at and nobody's going to care about? I am not spending my time on that. Get out of here. And so it's just, it's kind of that one thing is going to cock block me from getting the platinum. But this is why. And also, I don't understand why it always takes a very, like, no matter what the connection is, whether it's 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bars, it always takes a long time for the connection to actually show up in ranked, which doesn't happen anywhere else. Like, player matches, like, let me just go check it. I think let me just do this. I can do that. And then can I go check? Oh, I can't. Darn. Okay, well, whatever. Like, these don't take, I mean, you see they're already starting to pop up. These don't take anywhere near that long to pop up. I guess online lobby does, huh? Now that I think about it, the online lobby can definitely take a decent amount of time, because initially it just shows all those four bars, and then finally they settle into what the actual connections are. But yeah, this is my world of ranked. Like, there's just, some of you guys said, oh yeah, there's plenty of people playing. Maybe it's because, if I'm filtering by three bars or more, obviously where they're from doesn't matter. If it's three bars, it's three bars. But yeah, now you're just gonna probably see, I guess we're gonna see just a ton of zeros and ones now. Because it is searching further out from where I am, yeah. So there are plenty of people playing, I guess, just not on the West Coast. That's a little, but yeah, this is why, like, I'm probably not going to be recording very much. I mean, honestly, I'll probably just stop at ranked once I get what my rank is. I still can't believe that I don't have a color yet. Because I've played, I mean, you see over there, I played 5 matches here. I played 5 matches in lobbies. And then I want to say I've probably played around, I would say close to 15 in player matches. And so, like, initially, I thought it only took, like, it assigns you a color after 10 matches, right? And then that didn't happen. So I was like, oh, okay, maybe it's how many matches it takes you to get to 10 wins overall. But I'm very far past that now. And so I have no idea. I just want to be something besides bland, tired, old whiteness. I just want to play. I mean, I guess I could.
Please select your character.
I mean, I could show off some Susano, but if we're being honest, I should practice my Azreal. Because I'm still dropping some stuff. I'm still, but I shouldn't be. That was too late. Wow. Oh, Jesus. You're right, I don't know Hornet combos. This is a trial combo. I don't know. I mean, I assume there's probably something better than what's available in trial combos. Oh, wow. Oops, you were supposed to dash first, my bad. Because it gets them a bit of extra height, which allows this combo to work. That, and then you're supposed to confirm that properly. But I don't know if that's, so like, the old one. That doesn't seem like they get enough distance, does it? But that might be a screen position thing. Oh, now we're in the corner. Now it'll definitely not work. Oh, this isn't gonna work because I can't have that. I think that'll work. It looks like he got enough distance that time, so it might just be like a height thing dependent upon certain factors that I am not aware of yet. I don't know. I just don't know if that'll work. Wow. I really need to work on that. Like, that's unacceptable. Oops. That's what I want to do. I need to build that muscle memory to do that. Because who can hate extra damage? I want to do all of that. And I hope, hopefully that'll work. Unacceptable. Did that too late. Oh my god, I even tried to be careful. That's what happens. Like, when I try to be careful, I actually screw it up more. God. It's so pathetic. Oops. That works. Well, actually, I did start that combo with a... I'm an idiot. I'm an idiot. Please give me a match so I can stop embarrassing myself. Oh my god! I forgot the motion for Growler. So that might not work. Maybe I might have just done it too slow. I wanted to see if I could do the Rekkas afterwards and then do that. Did I just screw up Ford? Did I just screw up Ford? Oops. Okay, so that definitely doesn't work. All right. Did I even try? I don't think I even tried doing it into 6A or 2C6D. Hate you. Okay, so that works, and that gives me, what, 47? Oh, I did do it, 47-10. What could get me more damage? I always want, I mean, obviously, if it was a fatal counter. Like, being able to do something, because you can actually, that force is fatal, which is actually really cool. You see fatal counter. And you can do that off of, like, what can you do that off of? There's one that's actually in. I think you can might be able to do it in, oh, that's right. If you do. That works, eventually. If you actually hit it correctly. Oops. Come on, son! Oops. There we go. That's definitely not gonna work. But yeah, that gives you a fatal counter. I'm sure you can do some. Oh, what was the combo? And then you can, oh, okay, so you want to go, like, I saw Dogura do it. Dogura has not been around much in, basically, since, like, Evo of Chrono Phantasma. Like, he was barely around in Extend, and he was messing around with Nu and Hosmo back then. And there was a recent video where he played again, but you could tell, like, because he's been focusing on Guilty Gear, he's been getting really good with Sen, and he's been winning a bunch of tournaments in Guilty Gear. But, and so he's obviously taking a lot of time off from BlazBlue, and so he came back in, like, this one video, but you could definitely see he was very, very rusty. And, but he did one combo where he did that. He did 3 5Cs into whatever his DP is called, but then, like, he was up in the air, and then he dashed forward, because you can actually, when you're in the middle of this, you can cancel that into the forward dash, the first hit, which is really cool. I love that. So, like, he did, like, something like that, and then when he was coming back down, he landed, I think he landed an entire 5B, 5C into 5D, I want to say, like, on his way down, he landed, like, this entire chain, which obviously is not working at all there, but yeah, like, it looked so awesome. I love it so much. Oops. So it definitely has to be higher than that. Oops. Definitely wasn't it. Can't be using that. That was it. That's very close to it, but obviously he was up a little bit higher, and so it allowed him to land the air JD. So that's actually not that hard. Oops, I can't do that. I can't believe I haven't gotten a single rank match in all this time. And then, so they do tech, but if they don't tech and you do an immediate 2D, you can get a double weak point. And then if they do tech, you recover from 2D fast enough that you can still have time to do, like, a meaty 2A or 5A. So it's a really, solid setup, and it looks awesome. I love the way it looks, and I really want to actually learn. I want to nail down that combo, and of course, the upper weak point goes away. A little bit higher than that thing. Okay. Oops. Although... it does a little bit less damage. What if I did, like... mix those together a little bit? Okay, well, I gotta be faster than that. But yeah, so I think that'll give me a bit more damage. Because you can definitely do Growler in there. Okay, so I gotta be careful. Because I might run out of time. I think I can do it with Growler. I just gotta be faster about the inputs. Definitely can do it with Growler. Cool, cool, cool. Oops. This is fun. I usually don't like training mode, but figuring out combos like this, that's enjoyable. It's the discovery that's fun. It's the grinding to master that discovery that is not fun in any way, shape, or form. Oops, I'm an idiot. I need to stop doing that. I keep waiting. That's definitely going to do more damage, because that other one, that capped off at like the high 4200, right? And that's already a 43. Need to be a little bit higher than that. It's not the same, but it looks cooler. And I'll sacrifice 300 damage for style. Every time I will sacrifice 300 damage for style. But yeah, just, I gotta work on those. Like, I want to know if that works in the corner. That didn't even work a little bit. I guess, yeah, you can just do stuff like that. I don't know why I wouldn't just do stuff like that in the corner. Like, it's easier. Although, if you have both weak points in the corner... what? That's so awkward that it misses like that. Anyway, I'm gonna stop dicking around over here. It sucks that there's nobody here wanting to match up with me, but, you know, hopefully, maybe I showed you a little something. Level 32. Oh, I could have been playing No One Baby Daddy this entire time. Can you actually lose levels? Like, because I don't know how this works. Like, obviously, it used to be where, well, like, the old system was PSR, and you could fluctuate up and down with your PSR based on who you were winning against and all that stuff. And then, like, in Chrono Phantasma, you had the whole Dan system, although they did change that over to levels in, for the American version, and then, well, for English-speaking regions. And then they made that... what did they make that? It was levels 1 to 30, right? No. 1 to 35? Or was it 1 to 40? I can't remember. Something like that. But yeah, it was just like this, levels 1. But I can't remember if you could... I imagine you can go up and down. Like, what's the point of a ranking system where you can't lose ranking? Although, there are ranking systems that have been designed like that. So I wonder if this is kind of like... because it's so much cooler. The Japanese versions are so much cooler because you have, like, first Dan to, I think, 25th. And then after that, you get, like, special rankings. Like, you have Hades ranking and stuff like that. Beyond, I don't know if there's, you know, like, 5 different rankings beyond that to go up. But then it's just like, we have level 1 through 30. Yay! Obviously, it goes above 30 because that was 32. But it's just so dull in comparison, and that's boring, man. You want to have, like, special rankings, you want to feel special, seem special, and then you're not. Alright, well, we're clearly not going to get a match. So, thank you for watching. This has been Nate's terrible execution in display. Peace!